All right, so this is Taurus. Let's see what you get. All right, so let's see. Anything worth doing can be done, okay? So that means get to it. Don't think about it too much. You can get it done, all right? Let's see. Check out oracles. If you're subscribed, thank you so much. Truly appreciate your support. If you're not subscribed, would love for you to subscribe and support me in growing my channel. All right, so you have chameleon spirit, act as if. So this is about acting as if you already have it, okay? So that goes along with anything worth doing can be done. So just act as it, and so you will be manifesting. But also, that means you need to put in the work. And then boundaries, setting boundaries up, okay? For whatever it is that you're doing, or having boundaries, or not being so open about whatever it is that you're wanting to do. Keep quiet until it gets done. That's the best energy. And it's not because of envy or whatever, although that plays into it. But sometimes people disrupt your energy when you're really working on something. So it's just better to keep quiet until you get it done, and then it just sort of comes out when it's done. And so that way you don't have any setbacks. And then never-ending story, something that you feel is never-ending and constantly, you know, going round and round is sort of what I'm sensing. So that's why it's telling you to make sure that you create boundaries, that you have boundaries set, okay? This is also like keeping you stuck. So try to move and try to move the energy. How do you do that? Being present, and also like maybe doing chores. Chores is really good, like sweeping, washing dishes, doing laundry, all that. It's something that's repetitive, and sort of being monotonous really helps you with sort of, you know, just doing that over and over. And so that helps you be present, and it helps you move the energy. And then the line in between. So there's something that, you know, that you're crossing over to, or mending possibly, or finding an in between, something that you've overcome. Something that could be great. Okay. Know that you're in transition, so be patient with yourself. This is for Taurus. And then you have marine life. So maybe you want to be a marine biologist, or maybe you're near the beach or wanting to visit the beach, or maybe having to do with like emotions and really trying to balance those out and getting out of this very bad energy that you're in with creating boundaries, acting as if, and most definitely, moving forward. And then you have healer of all ages. You might be a healer, a shaman, or you might be healing, or you might be manifesting healing. And so that's coming through and alchemizing whatever it is that you're manifesting. And then you have surrender. Surrender to the journey. Okay, surrender to your intuition. You are being divinely guided. I think you're also doing like moon magic. You know, a lot of people don't know what that is, so that's when, you know, you use the moon cycles to propel the energy and to really propel the manifestations that you're trying to achieve. And then intuition, what did I tell you? Highly intuitive state right now, okay, which will create lots of balance. Your angels, your guides, your ancestors are very much taking care of you, really balancing out, watching over you, and protecting you. So don't worry, okay? There might be some major travel, like overseas, like Australia or China or something exotic like that that's coming. It didn't come out, but it's in the energy. So maybe you're thinking about it, or there might be like an opportunity having to do with work that you're gonna have to travel there, okay? And then tarot cards, guidance, most definitely. You might be a tarot reader, you might do your own tarot, or of course, you know, looking at tarot readers just like me, myself. So lots of spiritual guidance for that. And then we'll take one more, and then we'll start our tarot, okay? Let me get this. So this is yes, just say yes. Beautiful, all right? Say yes to the opportunities. Don't say yes to some random guy like at 3 o'clock in the morning in the alley, like I tell my students, you know, be mindful, but say yes. All right, let's do this is for Taurus. offer coming in. Might be like a job offer, slow and steady. Maybe you already applied for it, okay? Yeah, some stable offer that's coming, all right? From something you think hasn't been manifested, all right? Or an offer you gave that you're waiting on. Something you thought was that, you know, is ended, okay? Or something that you closed out that gave you a lot of anxiety or made you feel, you know, not well, or made you feel depleted financially or emotionally. That's something that you're trying to balance things out, and you're, you know, waiting for justice on that. Yeah, you're trying to balance out something that's familial or something having to do with huge stability, okay? You're praying for it and healing. Something having to do possibly with a child or a water sign that wasn't balanced. You're no longer waiting. This was a huge conflict for you. There was a lot of strife. You were very anxious at night, couldn't sleep, but you're sleeping better because you've released it and you're not going back and forth. This was also some sort of manipulation that you were going through, okay, having to do with finances or stability or some sort of love offer or apology, okay? But it set you free. You set yourself free from this mental prism that you sort of had yourself in, okay, having to do with waiting for a relationship that wasn't just and wasn't balanced, possibly not truthful, and lots of like fighting or no winning or not stable at all, okay? But the truth was exposed. I think you followed your intuition. You might be dealing with a Pisces or a Cancer, all right? You were enlightened, or someone ghosted you, or you feel like you went inward and you saw the truth about maybe lack of participation or lack of collaboration and lots of like conflict. Yeah, you saw the truth. You were no longer confused that this was not moving forward in any way after like a break. Yeah, after like a betrayal, non-truth, okay? Somebody had hurt you deeply, and something that was ended through like some sort of communication that came in with swiftly that was very like mean or harsh, that you had, that you felt like, you know, just like it was, you know, like you had to put up your guard or you had gone through a battlefield. Somebody might be coming back to want to stabilize or some sort of commitment. I think you feel it, all right? But I think you're sensing it. Yeah, they're wanting to come back to a stable relationship or a marriage of some sort after having left, all right? Somebody that was very in and out possibly, or I don't know, had something else or someone else, okay? Somebody that was very manipulative, having to do with other people and your stability and this relationship. There was some karma that played out. There was a judgment call on this, okay? Having to do with being stuck or like a love situation or something having to do with courage or possibly even ego as well. This was something that ended because there was no reciprocation and there was very little to offer, all right? This person might have been giving to other people as well, or not necessarily, but not giving to you. You're working on your foundation and your money, possibly a new house coming in or more stability. And you know the truth about this burden and this deception and betrayal that you lived. You already know that. You're no longer waiting and you're not feeling sorry for yourself at all, and you're not a victim. You found out that there would, like, they would be coming and going, having to do with maybe being promiscuous, doesn't have to be, and you just felt that, you know, you weren't independent, and so you walked away, all right? And you're wanting victory, which you have, and really working towards some sort of like wish fulfillment with maybe an endeavor or a business opportunity, okay? This might also have to do with like legal issues or severing things that are not stable for you, or opportunities that are not for you, okay? Or not given to you. This was a very toxic or lustful, I would say toxic dynamic, where you were involved possibly with soulmate, past love, or childhood friend, you know, and things were not going forward, and you really needed to create some boundaries, and you felt like there was always like fighting. And so there was a huge tower moment where you released and you went through self-love and you loved yourself, okay? And you're choosing yourself, and you might not want this offer that's coming into you, but because you're choosing self. Hope that helped. Love and light.